and you kind of roll out almost, yeah, going put the feet down. Then you float along near the raft, then when you're ready, you pull them back in, you guys pull each other back in. The one at the end of the trip is in a deep reservoir. So you can actually jump in on that one, and you don't have to get back in the raft, you can actually swim to the shore, it's right there, you walk out on the beach. And then the bus is there too, we're 5 minutes from our base where your clothes are. So have a think about that before you get in a blight.
Somebody went for a dip.
That's Mount Kananaskis. And that's very famous in this area. A lot of the locals and natives think of that as being the head of one of their chiefs looking down on them, keeping them safe. A lot of people climb on that rock face, that steep rock face. They climb on that rock face. You can hike to the top as well, and you can run down that scree slope. It's quite a popular one in this area. It's certainly very popular one.
You can run down that scree slope. It's not, what's the incline? Have you done it?
It's
I don't.
Yeah. is like downhill.
Now these trees are shaded. Oh well, this whole thing was under the river. But the river wasn't here. This was not the river. This was not the course of the river.
Swim spot. I went rafting in Utah and you had to duck all the way under a bridge, completely flat, or else you would hit your head.
Where was that?
Near Park City.
Yeah.
The river was high. The rafts were bigger too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Was it a motorcycle?
Yeah, I heard it.
Forward paddle!
You guys
are warming up there. Flying off.